Chapter 5, Goods and Financial Markets, the ISLM Model. In Chapter 3, we learned the determination of output in the goods market in isolation, taking the interest rate as given. In Chapter 4, we learned how interest rate is determined in financial markets in isolation, taking output as given. However, the interest rate affects output through investment, as you will see in this chapter, and output affects the interest rate through money demand. So it is necessary to consider the simultaneous determination of output and interest rates. Hicks and Hansen developed ISLM model to explain Keynesian analysis of how goods and financial markets interact to determine output and interest rate simultaneously. This requires simultaneous equilibrium in the goods and financial markets. Chapter 5 Outline 5-1 The Goods Market and the IS Relation 5-2 Financial Markets and the LM Relation 5-3 Putting the IS and the LM Relations Together 5-4 Using a Policy Mix 5-5 How does the ISLM model fit the facts? Goods and Financial Markets, the ISLM model. We looked at the goods market in Chapter 3 and financial markets in Chapter 4. In this chapter, we look at goods and financial markets together and understand how output and the interest rate are determined in the short run. John Hicks and Alvin Hansen call this framework the ISLM model. In the model developed in Chapter 3, investment was assumed to be constant for simplicity. In fact, investment depends on production Y, or sales, and the interest rate I, as equation 5.1 shows. The plus sign under Y and the minus sign under I indicate that an increase in sales leads to increase in investment, and an increase in interest rates leads to fall in investment. We continue to assume inventory investment equals zero, so production is always equal to sales. Note, now that investment is also a function of output, for a given value of the interest rate, demand is an increasing function of output for two reasons. Increase in output leads to an increase in income, disposable income, and hence consumption. Increase in output also leads to increase in investment. So equilibrium in the goods market becomes Y equals C plus I plus G, where C is a function of disposable income Y minus D, investment is a function of output Y, and interest rate I, and G is determined by government as a matter of fiscal policy. Equation 5.2 gives us the equilibrium condition in the goods market. It is called the IS relation. ZZ curve in figure 5-1 shows that demand for goods is an increasing function of output. Slope of ZZ less than 1, assuming that increase in output does not lead to a 1-for-1 increase in demand. Equilibrium requires that the demand for goods be equal to output. On the graph, equilibrium is at point A, where the 45-degree line cuts the demand curve. This shows equilibrium in the goods market for a given interest rate. 5-1, the goods market and the IS relation. ZZ is upward sloping because, for a given value of the interest rate, an increase in output leads to an increase in demand for goods through its effect on consumption and investment. ZZ is a curve rather than a line because we have not assumed that the consumption and investment relations in equation 5.2 are linear. ZZ is flatter than the 45-degree line because we have assumed that an increase in output leads to less than 1-for-1 increase in demand. The intersection of ZZ and the 45-degree line, point A, is the equilibrium level of output. Figure 5-2 shows the derivation of the IS curve. A, an increase in the interest rate decreases the demand for goods at any level of output, leading to a downward shift of the ZZ curve and a decrease in the equilibrium level of output. B, equilibrium in the goods market implies that an increase in the interest rate leads to a decrease in output. The IS curve is therefore downward sloping. Figure 5-3 shows shifts of the IS curve.
Changes in factors that decrease the demand for goods for a given interest rate shift the IS curve to the left. Changes in factors that increase the demand for goods given the interest rate shift the IS curve to the right. Changes in G, T, or C0 will shift the IS curve. Increase in T or decrease in G or decrease in C0 shifts IS to the left. Use Keynesian cross diagram to see how this happens. Note two important points about the IS curve. 1. Downward sloping IS curve. Equilibrium in the goods market implies that an increase in the interest rate leads to a decrease in output. 2. Shifting the IS curve. Changes in factors that increase the demand for goods given the interest rate shift the IS curve to the left, right. 5-2 Financial Markets and the LM Relation. Recall Chapter 4, where you saw the equilibrium condition in the financial markets given by the condition money supply M equal dollar Y times a function of the interest rate. Divide both sides of the equation by the price level P. This gives us the equation 5.3, which says real money supply M over P equals real income Y times a function of the interest rate I. Equation 5.3, which says real money supply is equal to real money demand, is the LM relation. In equilibrium, real money supply equals real money demand, which depends on real income Y and the interest rate I. Figure 5-4 shows the LM curve. The central bank chooses the interest rate and adjusts the money supply so as to achieve it. LM is horizontal at the interest rate chosen by the central bank. Putting the IS and LM relations together. IS relation is given by the equation Y equals C times a function of Y minus T plus I times a function of Y and I plus G. LM relation is given by the equation I equals I bar. The IS and LM relations together determine output. Diagram on next slide shows any point on the downward sloping IS curve corresponds to equilibrium in the goods market. Any point on the horizontal LM curve corresponds to equilibrium in financial markets. Only at the intersection, point A, are both equilibrium relations satisfied. 5-3. Putting the IS and LM relations together. Figure 5-5. The IS-LM model. Equilibrium in the goods market implies that an increase in the interest rate leads to a decrease in output. This is represented by the IS curve. Equilibrium in financial markets is represented by the horizontal LM curve. Only at point A, which is on both curves, are both goods and financial markets in equilibrium. At any other point other than A, the goods market or the financial market or both would be out of equilibrium. Together, IS and LM determine output and interest rate at which both markets are in equilibrium at point A where the two curves intersect. This is a very useful diagram for understanding impact of fiscal and monetary policies. Fiscal policy measures shift the IS curve. Monetary policy shifts the LM curve. Fiscal policy is implemented through changes in G or T or both, where G refers to government spending on goods and services and T refers to taxes minus transfers. Decrease in G minus T implies fiscal contraction or fiscal consolidation. Increase in G minus T implies fiscal expansion. Steps for analyzing the effects of changes in policy or exogenous variables. 1. Does it shift the IS curve and or the LM curve? 2. What does this do to the equilibrium output and the equilibrium interest rate? 3. Describe the effects in words. Figure 5-6 shows the effects of an increase in taxes. As you saw before, increase in taxes shifts IS curve to the left. In words, increase in taxes decreases disposable income and hence consumption. Equilibrium income will go down by a multiple of the initial decline in income. Economy moves from point A to A prime. Monetary policy is implemented through changes in the money supply by the central bank. Monetary expansion through an increase in money supply leads to lower I. This causes the LM curve to shift down. Monetary contraction or tightening through a decrease in money supply leads to increase in I. As a result, LM curve shifts up. Change in taxes has no effect on the LM curve. In general, a curve shifts in response to a change in exogenous variables that appear directly in the equation for that curve. Figure 5-7 shows the effects of a decrease in the interest rate as a result of an expansionary monetary policy. Monetary policy does not affect the IS curve, only the LM curve. Increase in money supply, monetary expansion, shifts the LM curve down. New equilibrium output is higher while new equilibrium interest rate is lower. The economy moves along the IS curve from A to A prime. Increase in money supply leads to a decrease in interest rate. Lower interest rate leads to increase in investment and in turn increase in demand and output. Now, consider the effect of monetary expansion on the components of demand. Consumption C increases because income increases. Government spending G remains unchanged. Investment I definitely increases since output Y is higher and interest rate I is lower, and they both lead to an increase in investment I. 5-4. Using a policy mix. Monetary fiscal policy mix is the combination of monetary and fiscal policies. Suppose that the economy is in a recession and output is too low. Both fiscal and monetary policies can be used to increase output. Figure 5-8, the effects of a combined fiscal and monetary expansion. The fiscal expansion shifts the IS curve to the right. A monetary expansion shifts the LM curve down. Both lead to higher output. Economy moves from point A to A prime, and equilibrium output increases from Y to Y prime. Figure 1 shows the US growth rate 1999 quarter 1 to 2002 quarter 4. The National Bureau of Economic Research concluded that the US economy was in a recession between March 2001 and December 2001, shown by the shaded time period, triggered by sharp declines in investment demand. Figure 2 shows the federal funds rate 1999 quarter 1 to 2002 quarter 4. The recession was met by strong macroeconomic policy response by the Federal Reserve, the central bank of the United States. The Fed cut the federal funds rate, interest rate, from 6.5% in January 2001 to 2% at the end of 2001. This is an example of the use of expansionary monetary policy to stabilize the economy. Figure 3 shows US federal government revenues and spending as ratios to GDP 1991 quarter 1 to 2002 quarter 4. As a result of the recession, events of September 11, 2001, and fiscal policy measures taken to deal with the recession. In addition to monetary policy measures taken by the Fed, President George Bush also cut taxes in 2001 and 2002 budgets. The events of September 11, 2001 also led to an increase in spending on defense and homeland security. Revenues declined and spending increased not only because of the slowing economy, but because Congress implemented an expansionary fiscal policy by cutting taxes and increasing spending. Focus: deficit reduction, good or bad for investment. Equilibrium in the goods market implies, recall chapter 3, I equals S plus T minus G. given private saving S, a lower government deficit, higher T minus G means higher investment I. However, a fiscal contraction lowers output, and so private saving S goes down by more than public saving T minus G increases, so investment I decreases. Short-run implication of deficit reduction is lower investment spending in the economy. Figure 5-9 shows the effects of a combined fiscal consolidation and a monetary expansion. The fiscal consolidation shifts the IS curve to the left. Economy moves from A to A prime. Output falls from Y to Y prime. However, if the fiscal consolidation is combined with the monetary expansion, it shifts the LM curve down. Economy moves from point A prime to A double prime. Equilibrium output increases to Y double prime, same as the level Y before the fiscal consolidation. This allows for the reduction in the deficit without a recession. 5-5. How does the ISLM model fit the facts? Because the adjustment of output takes time, we need to reintroduce dynamics. Consumers are likely to take time to adjust their consumption following a change in disposable income. Firms are likely to take time to adjust investment spending following a change in their sales. Firms are likely to take time to adjust investment spending following a change in the interest rate. Firms are likely to take time to adjust production following a change in their sales. Figure 5-10 shows the empirical effects of an increase in the federal funds rate. In the short run, an increase in the federal funds rate leads to a decrease in output and to an increase in unemployment, but it has little effect on the price level. Figure 5-10 supports the assumption of fixed prices and the assumption that in the short run, production responds to demand without a change in prices, and therefore, output depends on demand in the short run.